Welcome friends to TV Box Top, the channel for the best reviews in TV boxes, mini PCs and accessories. Today I have another Windows Desktop Mini PC from Beelink, one of the top brands for mini PCs in the industry. This is the Beelink Mini-S 11th generation Intel Celeron Windows 11 Mini PC. So in this video, as usual, we'll take a look at the quality of its hardware and what facilities are available for expandable memory and storage. I'll test its Windows operating system for performance when applied to activities such as office applications, 4K video playback, surround sound audio, video editing and 3D gaming. And finally, I'll test its expandable storage facility with alternative operating systems such as Android x86 and FydeOS, and we'll determine if this mini PC suits our needs. So stay tuned, that's up next. So in this package contains the new Mini-S model itself, one 40 inches HDMI cable, another shorter 10 inches HDMI cable, a 12 volts 3 amps DC power adapter, a bracket and a pack of screws for mounting to the back of your monitor, and a user manual. So the body of this mini PC is made of aluminum and it has two HDMI 2.0 display ports, one RJ45GB LAN port, two USB 3.0 ports, its DC power socket, a Kensington lock, and its intake vent to the rear. To the front has two more USB 3.0 ports, a headphone jack, a clear CMOS pinhole button, and its LED power button. To both sides has exhaust vents. And below this PC, you have screw holes for mounting the included bracket, four anti-skid rubber feet with screw holes for removing the bottom panel, which gives access to its RAM module, the M.2 SATA SSD, and its SATA expandable storage facility. So before I reassemble the bottom panel, I will install a 1TB Western Digital SATA SSD into the compartment. So this mini PC boots up for the first time like any other with the Windows 11 first startup wizard, where you have to connect to your network and log in to your Microsoft account. So here I've successfully logged into Windows 11, and first, let's take a look at its basic system and hardware information. It says here that the CPU is the Intel Celeron N5095 with a base clock speed of 2.0 GHz. It has 8GB of RAM and it's a 64-bit operating system. And under product key and activation, it shows that this version of Windows 11 is activated. For a bit more in-depth information, Intel's CPU information page shows that the N5095 has a base clock speed of 2.0 GHz and a boost clock speed of 2.9 GHz with 4 cores and 8 threads. The Ada 64 Extreme app shows that it comes with a single 8GB DDR4 2666 SDRAM module, and the product page shows that it can take up to a single 16GB module with a maximum speed of up to 2933MHz. Its GPU is the Intel UHD Graphics 11th generation, and it has a maximum resolution of up to 4K 2160p at 60Hz, and it has 16 processing units with a base frequency of 450 MHz and a burst frequency of 750 MHz. For storage, its main disk running its operating system is an M.2 NGFF 2280 256GB SATA SSD with a maximum read speed of 500 MHz. Here you can also see the Western Digital 1TB SATA SSD installed into the expandable storage facility. And its Wi-Fi adapter is the Intel Dual Band Wireless AC3165 that has 5GHz Wi-Fi support with Bluetooth 5.2 technology. So that's its advanced system and hardware information. Let's now take a look at its performance benchmarks before I get into some live demonstrations. First, its RAM copy speed and its M.2 SATA SSD read and write speeds. The Nova Bench app shows that it has a RAM copy speed of 9,177 megabytes per second. Its M.2 SATA SSD has a read speed of 349 megabytes per second and a write speed of 454 megabytes per second. The test performed on its Wi-Fi bands and Ethernet LAN port based on my network speed of 250 megabits per second, the 5 GHz band and the gigabit LAN port achieved maximum bandwidth. The 2.4 GHz band achieved only 20%. The Geekbench 5 CPU benchmarking app shows that it has a boost clock speed of up to 2.88 GHz, which resulted in a score of 642 single core and 1874 multi-core. To benchmark its GPU, the Intel UHD graphics has Vulkan support with OpenGL ES version 3.4, and in this test, it got a score of 203 in the time spy test. In the PC Mark 10 comprehensive benchmark, it got an overall score of 2,065, with a video editing score of 2,052 and a web browsing score of 3,466. These additional scores will be added to the rankings chart, and the iStorm Extreme and the CloudGate test will be removed as they are no longer relevant. The final benchmark is the PC version of the AnTuTu benchmark, and in this test, it got a score of 209,480. That's the last of the benchmarks. Let's now see where it places on the rankings chart. So I've entered the scores on my rankings chart, and the new Beelink Mini-S is at position number 8 in reference to PC Mark 10 benchmark scores, which is not too bad, but these benchmarks are just a guide for selecting the best hardware. Let's now see what we can actually do with this mini PC. Also, you can view this chart on my blog using the link in the description directly below this video. First, let's start with its basic function with Office applications. Here, I installed Microsoft Office and it works perfectly with apps such as Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. For display, you have up to 4K 2160p at 60Hz with HDR. You also have screen orientation to portrait mode. If you intend to play 4K HDR videos, I recommend that you open the Microsoft Store and enter the search term extension, and ensure that the HEVC extension, the VP9 extension, the AV1 video extension, and the MPEG-2 video extensions are installed. This is to ensure that the default movie and TV player can play your 4K HDR videos without the need for a third-party app such as VLC. So I'll now play my list of 4K HDR videos.
Only a win for Barca would be enough, because it would give them the same number of points as Atletico, but the head-to-head goal difference is what counts in the case of a tie on points. The mosaic of the Camp Nou.
So the videos appear to play smoothly, but there are some slight skip frames and latency at the beginning of each video. If you would like surround sound audio with apps such as Netflix and others, or you have self-hosted videos in surround sound formats, you will first have to connect it to a 5.1 or 7.1 audio receiver, where on the speaker setup, you'll be given the option to select Dolby Atmos or DTS:X. If you don't connect it to a receiver, these options will not be available. So here I have it connected to my Sony 7.1 surround sound receiver, and I'll play my list of videos with Dolby and DTS formats.
This is Dolby Atmos, the world's first object-based cinematic audio. With powerful moving audio that transcends from channels, to moving around you with pinpoint accuracy.
This is the left channel. Next, we have the center channel. Over here is the right channel.
So from this test, it shows that the Mini-S can output Dolby Atmos, DTS:X, DTS HD Master Audio, Dolby Surround from Dolby Vision videos, and Dolby True HD. While connected to your receiver and configured in 7.1 surround sound speaker configuration, if you open the Netflix app and search for a 4K movie, you will be able to watch them with Dolby Atmos surround sound audio. The same applies for Amazon Prime Video. For video editing, I installed Camtasia and loaded a 4K clip from this video, and it seems to be handling the edits with a slight bit of difficulty, so I would recommend that you only edit 720p and 1080p videos. This mini PC comes with dual HDMI ports, and it also has the ability to cast to a third display wirelessly, all at the same time for extended display, which comes in handy for setting up a mini workstation, multitasking, or casting to a TV that's on the other end of the room. As for its gaming performance, I wouldn't recommend it for any high-end gaming, because when I attempted to play high-end games, it could only render 12 frames per second with low graphics, as you can see with Destiny 2 and Apex Legends. However, when I installed lower-end games from the Microsoft Store, it played smoothly without issues.
In reference to the derelict Cabal cruiser, Glycon Volatus. This does not bode well.
The perfect line shows you the best route and speed around the track.
We'll be right back.
So that's it for its Windows operating system. And as mentioned in my intro, I would now attempt to install alternative operating systems using its expandable storage facility and attempt to convert it into an Android TV box independent of its Windows operating system. So here I successfully installed Android 12x86 and it's fully functional with Google Play Store and Play services working with updates. With Android x86 running on this Windows hardware, its CPU is clocked at 2.9 GHz, which is its boost clock speed. You get 64-bit architecture, which means you can run 64-bit apps and games. Its GPU is clocked at 750 MHz with OpenGLES version 3.2 support. Its idle operating temperature is around 28 degrees Celsius. And it has Dolby Atmos and DTS HD decoders. And once again, you don't get audio via its HDMI port, only through its headphone jack. Installing Android x86 on these 11th generation Intel SoCs is not the same as previous models and require registering EFI keys into the secure boot feature. I will have to create a new Android x86 installation tutorial video for this new process. If you are really looking for a more complete solution to running Android on this mini PC, then I suggest you install the FydeOS operating system. Here I installed the latest Intel version 14.2 9th to 11th generation version, and it installs by simply disabling the secure boot feature in the BIOS. With FydeOS, you get its CPU clocked at 2.9 GHz with 64-bit ABIs to run 64-bit apps and games. You get audio via its HDMI drivers directly to your TV or monitor. You can watch Netflix and other premium movie apps in HD using the Chromium browser. You get full access to the Google Play Store with Google Play services and updates. And you get a high-performance Android gaming machine.
Stark.
Leave this one to the heroes, MODOK.
So with the Mini S, you can enjoy your Windows operating system and you can convert it into a full-fledged Android TV box on expandable storage. If you would like to learn how to install these alternative operating systems using expandable storage, see the links to my tutorial in the description below this video. In summary, the Beelink Mini-S is a great all-round mini PC to buy that comes with Windows 11 fully functional out of the box, and you have the ability to install alternative operating systems via its expandable storage facility. Its Wi-Fi and Bluetooth works great, and you have the option to upgrade your RAM and internal M.2 SSD. The only issues I had with this model is that it's not very good at playing 4K videos, and its gaming performance is not the best but playable when reduced to 1080p medium grade graphics. So friends, I've come to the end of this review. The Mini S is currently being sold on Amazon, where you can get the 256GB model for $169 with a further $20 coupon, and the 128GB model for $152 with the same $20 coupon. To take advantage, see the link in the description below this video. So give this video the thumbs up if you think this mini PC is amazing. Special thanks to Beelink for their continued support and for sending this mini PC for review. If you are viewing for the first time, be sure to hit that like and subscribe button, along with the notifications bell to be notified when I release new videos or decide to do a giveaway. Links in the description are my affiliate links, and when you use them to purchase or just to simply view the product, you support this channel in a big way and provide the means for me to acquire new products for review. So go ahead, view the product, and thanks in advance for using my links. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.